My name is Yimin Yang. I'm a solution engineer at Sauce Labs. In this video, we are going to take a look at live testing using web browsers and virtual machines. To get started, we are going to expand the live menu on the left side and click on Cross Browser. If you already have a specific website in mind to test on, you can paste the link into this text field here, or you can just enter a new one. In this case, I'm going to use sourcedemo.com, which is Sauce Labs' own built demo website. Sauce Labs supports the most popular browsers in the market in hundreds of different versions. We also support testing on development and better versions of the browsers. For example, we have Firefox in the latest version 81, but we also support the version in development and better, which is respectively 82 and 83. But we also go back a long while until version 4. On the right side here, you can select the resolution you want to test on. And here on the left side, you can select the different OS versions you want to run your browser on. We have Windows 10 and multiple other Windows versions, as well as multiple macOS versions. For this test, I'm going to select Chrome version 86. I'm going to leave the resolution as it is, and I'm also going to leave the OS version as it is. To start the test, we need to click on the Start Session. We will spin up a new pristine machine and install the browser on it. We have different data centers worldwide, in the US and in Germany. I can now interact with this browser the same way I would do with my own browser on my home computer. For example, I can use my keyboard to type in a username. I can use the tab key to jump to the next text field. And now I can use my mouse to click on login. I can also use my mouse, for example, to right click on the website. And I can inspect it, for example. I can also add something to my cart, for example, like in this case. Here on the right side, we have some more functionalities available. For example, the invite button here will create a unique link, which you can share with a colleague within your organization. Using that link, the colleague can watch in live what you are doing at the moment. That means it is easier to collaborate together because you can exactly show him or her what you are doing, and that makes it a lot easier to collaborate. On the right side, we also have the ability to take a screenshot. The screenshot is now saved on my computer here, and I can add it easily to a bug tracking or defect tracking system. After I'm done with my testing here, I can click on Stop Session here in the top right. This just now deleted the VM and the browser, so no data is saved. To take a look at the test results, we can now click on Test Results here on the left side. We now select this one here, the live session in the first row, which is the session we just created 2 minutes ago. In the center of the screen, we can see there's a video, and this video captured everything we just did in live testing. I will skip a bit forward. This video is automatically captured and saved in our cloud for up to 30 days. Afterwards, these type of media files will be deleted. On the right side here, we can see different tabs. The first one, commands, will show us the different Selenium commands sent to this browser. In this case, because it was a live testing, we only see a handful ones. In the case of automated testing, we would see a lot more different commands here on the right side. When we click on View Logs here, we can see we have different logs available to us, log.json and in Selenium Server Log, which helps a lot to debug issues, but also helps in the case of auditing or if you need to preserve the test data for your own record keeping. On the Metadata tab, we can see metadata for this test. And here on the bottom, we can download screenshots and video. The video is on the left side, and the screenshots are taken when the DOM tree of the website changes. Together with the log files, the screenshot and videos will be kept for 30 days and then deleted afterwards automatically. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Thanks a lot for watching.